Triathletes, welcome back to another session with TriathlontesSA, where today I'll be sharing with you guys what it takes to qualify for Kona. So stay tuned as I use the website to try and explain to you guys what times you more or less need to acquire when you want to qualify for Kona.
To accomplish something extraordinary, one must have an extraordinary dream. Ironman inspires us to reimagine our limits, to set our sights higher, to go farther than we ever have before. Ironman is a statement of excellence, passion, commitment. It is a test of physical toughness and mental strength. Ironman is about persevering, enduring, and being a part of something larger than ourselves. It shows the heights that can be achieved when we push beyond our boundaries and go the distance to earn the title Ironman.
First off, you need to go to your Internet Explorer and go and type in OBS Tri. I'll put the link for this site in the description as well, so you can follow the link as well. So let's go into OBS Tri. I found that this is the easiest website for me to get information regarding how to qualify for Kona. If you look at the site, you'll see the upcoming races, 70.3 or Ironman. And then over there, you'll see you can either find a specific athlete to track their progress. You can go to fastest. That will give you the fastest all time for males or females, depending on what you select over here. And then you can go and look at stats. That's the number of races, overall entries for Ironman and 70.3 as well. You can even go and look at the rankings, and it will start off with the pros and then go down to the age groupers as well. So let's go to races, and then I'll try and qualify for Kona in South Africa. So I'll go to Africa region, and then you can either say race all, the swim all, the bike all, the run all. We can sort them according to date. This will just give you the overall times. The swim will just give you the swim time, the bike time, and the run time. So let's go down to Ironman South Africa. If you look at Ironman South Africa, it will show you whether it's an ocean swim or a lake swim. And then it will also show you the bike or the run difficulty of that specific course and tell you the date of the next race as well. So let's dig into Ironman South Africa. So here over here, you'll find the different years the race was held. And over there, you'll find the different age categories as well. So you'll have the females and you'll have the males. I'll go to my age category, which will be 35 to 39. And then I'm not going to select 2019, as course was shortened for 2019 due to bad weather. So first off, you can go to results and it will show you the first to the last person within this age category. It will show you the swim time, the bike time, the run time, and the overall time. And this is how they did according to the rest of the field. And then you can go to the course, go and check out the course or the weather, or you can go to stats. So let's first off start with stats. Over here, you can first off or look at the overall times, and then I'll just select, I want to look at specifically age category 35 to 39, and the median will show you the averages, but I want to look at the fastest times recorded. So let's first start off with the overall times. I'll ignore 2019 as the swim course was shortened. So if I look at 2018, the first female finished in 10 hours and 13 minutes. If I go and look at 2017, the first female age 35 to 39 finished in 9 hours and 50 minutes. And if I look at 2016, the first female age 35 to 39 finished in 9 hours and 17 minutes. I can also go and look at their swim times. What was the fastest times recorded for the swims in the 3 years, as well as the bike and the run as well. So you can look at them separately as well. So let's go to the result, as I want to see how the first couple of people did in my age category 35 to 39. So usually how it works, if you want to qualify for Kona, they'll allocate a certain number of slots for a specific race. It's usually between 50 and 100 slots, depending on how many is available for that specific race. And then they'll give one slot to each age category. So for males 25 to 29, there'll be at least one slot. And for females aged 25 to 29, there'll be one slot. So each age category will be allotted one slot, and then the remaining of the 50, 75 or 100 slots will be divided according to how many people entered for a specific age category. So for instance, say there was 300 people entered for age category 35 to 39, and there was only 2 people entered for age category 50 to 54. Then they would rather give a slot for age category 35 to 39 instead of 50 to 54. Once the slots are allocated per age category, they will usually have between 1 to 3 slots, depending on how many they allocated in the beginning. Then once they've allocated to a specific age category, for instance, females 35 to 39, and let's say there was 2 slots available for that specific age category, once the race is complete, they'll start at the top and pull out the names of the people that finished. If the first person does not claim the slot, it will roll over to the second person. The second person does not claim the slot, it will roll over to the third person. And this will go on until 2 people of that age category has claimed the slot. If there's age categories where people did not claim the slots, that slot will also roll over to age categories with the most people in line. So for me, I'll focus on the top 5 people of my age category, as usually the top 5 athletes don't all take their slots. So if I look at the top 5 athletes, you'll see that their finishing times will range from 10 hours and 13 minutes all the way to 10 hours and 55 minutes. And if I look at the individual times, the first person swam 58 minutes and the fifth person swam in 1 hour. So that means I need to swim somewhere between a 1 minute 27 to a 1 minute 30 pace per 100 meter to have more or less their swim times. If I look at the bikes, you'll see the first person biked a bit slower than the fifth person, so let's look between 5 hours and 34 minutes and 5 hours and 43 minutes. That would be more or less between 31 and 32 kilometers per hour. If I look at the run splits, you'll see that the top person finished in 3 hours and 22 minutes and the fifth person finished in 4 hours and 11 minutes. That means that I need to run somewhere between a 4:45 minute per kilometer all the way to a 6 minute per kilometer. And then they did not show you the T1 and T2, but you can get that if you subtract swim, bike and run from the overall time, and the average transition, which will include T1 and T2, be more or less 11 to 12 minutes long. So these times will give me an indication on how hard I need to work to try and qualify for Kona within the next 5 years. If you've watched my previous 2 videos, you'll see that I'm going to incorporate some changes from my 2021 season, as my 2020 season will end at the end of March with the Ironman. So the first thing that I'll change is I'll change my training season so I can incorporate an off season as well as a base building phase, which I never had before, as I had too many races scheduled in 1 year. So I never gave my body any recovery, and I never focused on building a base great enough to finish an Ironman. So this will be the first major change that I make trying to qualify for Kona. The second thing that I've spoke about in one of my previous videos, my training week will look different as well. Previously, I had 14 training sessions a week with hard sessions almost every day. So there was no recovery built into my training week as well. So for the 2021 season, I have my long rides and runs over the weekend, and then I'll have the hard sessions between Tuesday and Thursday. And then Monday and Friday will be reserved for recovery sessions as well. So that would be the 2 major changes that I'll make from my 2021 season. And then I have 21, 22, 23, 24, and 2025 to try and qualify for Kona. I hope this information has helped you as well, and you are more than welcome to check out the site for your specific age category. So you can go to your specific race that you want to compete in. Say for instance, you want to compete in a race in Europe, and say for instance, you want to compete in Ironman Barcelona. And once again, you can go and select the year as well as the age category, and you can go and look at the stats for that specific race as well. So you can use this for any 70.3 or Ironman sanctioned race to determine what times you need to reach to qualify for Kona within your age category.
Please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, as well as my Facebook group or Instagram as TriathlontesSA. And also stay tuned for the next video, where I'll show you guys different methods that you can use to record your training sessions. So keep up the training, triathletes, and see you guys soon.